JRay501 here. I'm in alwayscheckTheEvidence.com, and I did some research on Mr. Richard Hoagland after I did a video based on his information about the tetrahedral shield surrounding Elenin. And somebody had sent me a message saying that I needed to be very cautious when using any of his work because they thought he was a government disinfo agent, and he's been around forever. So this is one of the articles that I came up with. This is written by Andrew Johnson. Readers of other articles I've written will perhaps be wondering why I now seem to be writing an article about Mr. Richard Hoagland, a well-known researcher who is a regular guest and contributor to the popular alternative late-night U.S. syndicated talk show Coast to Coast. Mr. Hoagland is billed as the science advisor to the program, though he does not have any formal qualifications in science subjects. Mr. Hoagland, however, did apparently work as a curator for NASA for some time, and he also worked with the famed CBS reporter Walter Cronkite, presumably on reports relating to NASA and or the Apollo and other space missions. Starting in about 1983, Mr. Hoagland has presented some very interesting information about Mars, the Moon, and especially Lapidus, and he and others have highlighted a number of anomalies in various photos which have been sent back by unmanned probes. Mr. Hoagland has posted some quite fascinating, if at times verbose, articles on his website Enterprise Mission. He has mainly focused on space-related research topics, and he has covered these at length in books such as Monuments of Mars and more recently Dark Mission. Readers of some of his articles may conclude that Mr. Hoagland is something of a trekker, although, unlike this author, Mr. Hoagland apparently knew Gene Roddenberry for some time. Outside of space research, Mr. Hoagland posted a very interesting series of articles about the so-called Norway spiral. However, in July 2010, he stated on Coast to Coast that a large undersea region in the Gulf of Mexico could explode from a methane buildup causing a tsunami. That hasn't happened yet. With this said, it can perhaps be seen why I was interested that on Sunday, April 3rd, Mr. Hoagland gave a presentation in Amsterdam as part of a conference entitled The Secret Space Program. In August 2010, I was made aware of the organizer, Jerome Van Straten, that this conference would be happening. So actually, the author was not able to make it. Let's see. But it does appear some readers may know of my special interest in 9/11, which is Dr. Judy Wood's specialty. She's got some very interesting theories. So it appears that Mr. Hoagland, I guess, started talking about Judy Wood's work and yet didn't really give her any credence or credit. So there was some question as to why he was even bringing her up. It didn't make any sense. And he goes on and on and quotes the exact times and what was said and whether or not it was appropriate or not. And then he also started using the author's information as well, but never contacted Judy Wood to discuss her research or her theories, but went into details discussing them in a presentation platform. So, and I guess he was seriously wrong on some of the evidence that he brought up, Both myself and especially Dr. Wood work very hard to get details correct. And, you know, I'm kind of all about that myself. If I'm not sure about something, I'll usually say I'm going to go do more research or ask people, you know, if you know something, let me know. Science and engineering are nothing without details being correct. Hence, we both felt we needed to point out where there are mistakes in his presentation so we can ensure a true and accurate record of these matters becomes available to people. Okay, and there's many, many quotes and stuff in here, which I kind of find interesting, that somebody would go to this extent to, you know, debunk somebody else that's misusing their information. Mr. Hoagland's presentation is peppered with jokes and buzzwords. Do jokes enhance or suppress someone's critical thinking? Is it the case that non-scientists can use scientific-sounding buzzwords repeatedly to make an audience think they are an authority on a given subject? Remember, Mr. Hoagland does not have a science degree. Dr. Judy Wood has completed 3 science degrees, postdoctoral research, and has been a university professor in her area of expertise. Dr. Wood has observed in her book that using a buzzword can often discourage people from thinking about the details of a phenomenon, and therefore they are less likely to develop an understanding of it. Omissions. Even though Mr. Hoagland's presentation lasted the best part of 3 hours, there were many significant omissions. Here are a few. Seismic evidence. They're talking about the 9/11. And I guess that, you know, really bothered him. Summary of what we have observed so far. Mr. Hoagland described the Quitom case incorrectly, trivializing it. He stated several times that Judy was in error or did not know what happened. He made errors about John Hutchinson and also stated that John had no clue what he was doing, and yet John Hutchinson has worked with the military in what he does. He does have a clue what he's doing. He made serious omissions which prevented people from gaining a full and coherent picture of evidence. It seems clear that in large part Mr. Hoagland has misrepresented Dr. Wood's research. He presented her analysis as his own while implying she was clueless about what happened. 3 years ago, Mr. Hoagland was still promoting the 9/11 bin Laden story. 4 years ago, Dr. Wood submitted her analysis in a federal Quitam case. This is a matter of public record. So do Dr. Wood and Mr. Hoagland didn't just happen to discover the same thing at the same time? Okay. So I just thought that this was interesting. I'm going to leave the link. You can go in here and do some reading on your own. There are other sites that are debunking. Here's actually a email response from Mr. Johnson to John Hutchinson, asking about a statement that Mr. Hoagland said in one of his presentations, and it was straight up wrong. So, you know, there's an awful lot of evidence here that Mr. Hoagland has strayed from what he thinks he really knows, which is Moon, Mars, and things like that. But even that tetrahedral video that I made, those were photographs that he stacked on top of each other. So those were not original photographs. Those were photographs that Mr. Hoagland, how do I say it? Not doctored. He manipulated That's a better word. He manipulated those photographs. So is he manipulating the photographs in his favor so that he can be like this famous hero that, look at what I found, what I discovered? I don't know. I have no idea. I'm just asking questions. Okay, so just food for thought right now. There's so much disinformation out there, and people aren't doing any research. They're just going, oh yeah, okay, yes, this, that, the other. And I'm quite the skeptic, and I always will be. So, just my two cents. Thought I'd put that out there. Share that with you too. God bless.